experience. But when we were asked, I was told, well, he has a need. And I remember when I was in a horrible pit, and I had a need. And God pulled me out of that pit, out of that miry clay. And I don't know if I've been doing this for a long time, and I don't know if I've met anybody that has had more clay on than Chuck. His mother searched far and wide to get somebody to take him in a rehab center, and she heard nothing but no. But God. When I was asked, I said, yeah, because when I was at Teen Challenge back in the 80s, I went through Teen Challenge, and we had a young man that was a paraplegic. There was a wheelchair. And I saw what the power of God could do, not only in my life, but in his life. And we didn't know that we could handle it. We did not know what we were in for. It's a mess.
But look at him now. Thank you, Pastor Mark. My name is Chuck Findley. Thank you for letting me come here. I'd like to start with a scripture for my testimony. 1 Peter 2:9. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of them who crawled out of darkness into light. Anyways, a little bit about Bruce Summery. I grew up in Houston, Texas. I was in a normal household. My mom gave me love and care. My dad always made sure we had food and roof over our head. He was an alcoholic. I started going to bars with my dad around 5-6 years old. And I was exposed at a really young age to alcohol and drugs. My dad didn't pull me out of school, and I'd go play pool with him and stuff. I was exposed at a really young age. But I still made good grades. I was a loving kid, had lots of friends. I made it through high school. After high school, I did a few welding jobs, and then I got introduced to cocaine and Xanax and started using those. And I want to fast forward. I'm in this wheelchair because I was drinking and driving. One night I did a lot of cocaine and Xanax and drank a lot of liquor, and I blacked out behind the wheel. Before that, I had just lost 2 jobs and I was homeless. So I stole one of my grandpa's cars off of his car lot, and I hit a light pole. And now I'm injured at the T7 in my spinal cord and had little to no feeling, no movement inside my legs whatsoever. And that started the downward spiral of addiction. I would put any substance I can, I would sleep with any woman I can, just so I could numb out the feelings from being not able to walk. Y'all guys gotta understand, you have that movement, like when you wake up each day, you have that instinct to move, right? Well, when you wake up and don't have that, all that depression and anguish just hits you. You feel like half a man. I really do. And I was just trying to use drugs to numb everything. And I lost everything after my accident. I was on and off the street, in motels, sleeping around, using drugs, using needles, doing everything I could just to numb the pain. While my mom was back home just wondering who her son is, you know what I mean? I was in some deep, dark pits. Just like what Pastor Mike talked about, I think that he knows some of the streets I used to go down. And I'm telling him this, and he thinks it's crazy how I survived. And I've always had Jesus, but I was far away from him. I know when you get out of the light into the darkness, that's when the enemy has the hold on you. And I finally got a warrant for my arrest, and I was facing 2 to 10 years in TDC for assault towards a peace officer, and they picked me up on a warrant, and I was so crazy in Harris County Jail in Houston. They threw me in solitary confinement because of all the psychedelics and psychotropics and benzos and opiates I'd been on. My mind was just gone. I was in solitary confinement. It was locked down 24 hours a day. And I look over to my right and I see the New Testament Bible. And I'm like, I'm gonna give this a shot. You know, I went into a Baptist church just like this when I was a kid, but I was scared of God because I always felt condemned. I always felt condemned, like God was after me. So I pick up this New Testament Bible and I read Matthew 4 of the temptation of Jesus. And I'm like, I have something in common with this Jesus guy. If he gets tempted by the devil, I get tempted by the devil every day. So that's when I gave myself to God. And then I got a knock on my cell. I went to court and I found this place called New Creations. And here I am. And it has definitely saved my life. You know, I went through the program. I learned who I am in Christ. I learned that I am righteous through Christ Jesus. And I tried to rely on what he does and not what I do, even though it's so hard sometimes. It's all about me. But it shouldn't be about that. It's about him. And I'd like to read this. Okay, I gotta have perseverance through this. Like a soldier, we are in a war that we can win only if we fight to the end. Like an athlete, we must train for a new way of life and follow the steps of recovery to finish line. Like a farmer, we must do our work in every season and then wait patiently until we see growth. If we stop working our program before reaching the goal, we may lose everything we have fought and trained and worked hard for. And furthermore, I gotta have self-protection. Recovery is not a battle anyone wins alone. We here at New Creations help each other to think and live in new ways. Alone like most of my brothers in the world, we were all vulnerable to temptation. Together we form a shield of protection for one another. And I'd like just to thank Pastor Mike and all my brothers every day, even when I'm in a bad mood or something, somehow I get uplifted because you can feel the spirit in our program. And that's a fact. So thank y'all very much.
You know,